Before we formally start this meeting, I would request my director, Dr. D. Rama Rao Saab, to kindly present flower bouquet to our DDG education.
It's indeed a very happy occasion for the Academy to have the key persons from the agricultural education system in the country to assemble here to discuss. It's 6 years back, I think, we happened to have this type of conclave with the finance officers, with the FADG at that time, to sort out, kickstart the NAIP at that time, since it was a new program. Whenever ICR wanted to bring a change, we bring them here and we discuss, we put forward, exchange ideas, try to understand each other. That's what the Academy does. We provide a platform for sharing of ideas, functioning like a think tank to ICR. We would like to put forward what ICR is contemplating to do, because we have a great responsibility of taking, reviving the agricultural education, improving the quality. I hope that our DDGs and ADGs will lay some emphasis on that and will also put the importance of this particular meeting.
You know that this meeting is probably after 2009 we are meeting with the controllers. And if you see our agricultural education division, we do not administer the agricultural university, but we coordinate the agricultural university for the higher agricultural education, for its relevance, for its quality resource, quality education, agricultural education at country level. Already our director Nam here has mentioned, given a clues that we are going to have some new programs also. So this is the kind of an interface meeting, an interactive meeting where we can sit in front of each other and we can share our experiences, we can share our problems, and at the same time obviously the solution. And that's why this is the meeting which we wanted long back, sir. And many issues we are going to deliberate, and for this reason also we have requested, I'm thankful to our director Nam, that he kindly enough to arrange a leadership lecture by Dr. Raj Sekharan. He is going to share with his experience, because he has also a very vast experience working in different organizations, and that too in your same domain areas. So this is the very appropriate.
It was the idea of our Honorable DDG that why not to meet the controllers, so that the information should be two ways. Otherwise, only information going from the ICR to universities is not correct, and we also need to have the feedback from the controllers and what are the difficulties the controllers are facing. So that's why this interactive meeting has been convened here at NAM. And one more thing our DDG has kept in mind, and he keeps telling us that we also need to have such meetings of the deans, because the implementation part of most of the programs of the ICR, especially of the education division, is by the deans of the respective colleges. So even we may have in near future the meeting of the deans also. We have been having the meeting of deans for different purposes, like accreditation purpose, but in the sectoral way we are having the meeting of the deans. But we can have the common meeting of the deans. We are planning in that direction. Our DDG is very keen to have even the meeting of the deans also.
NARM has got its own identity. You will definitely appreciate Dr. Rama Rao is sitting here, and he has introduced a number of good reforms as far as the National Academy of Agriculture Research and Management is concerned. And this is one of the institute which falls under our education division. And these people are giving a right type of direction as far as the education is concerned. Even they are training the new faculty member, senior colleagues, as well as the dean and director. So that type of program they are launching. So I thought that this is the right place where we will discuss, because discussing in a place where some education is already available, then things will be in a right way. That's why we have invited all of you. Maybe possible, because I can see my colleague from Rajasthan and even from our Jammu to Kerala, and all have represented this interactive meeting. So I can understand that type of pain which you have taken in coming to this place. So you all deserve appreciation, because it gives an impression. Now I can get out of this all, your presence itself giving me a right type of a boosting and giving me a right type of a strength that we are in the right track as far as our education is concerned. You must be knowing that in ICR itself, education has got its own identity, and perhaps we have got a highest budget available, and it is the only reason, because we are having a direct link with the number of a university. Things which is available in this country, you are also one of the important stakeholder for making the right type of a denting. So that's why, keeping these all things in mind, we have decided that let us discuss the things first of all with our comptroller. Later on we will discuss, although we are in the process of developing a complete new, altogether new education policy. In coming year, a new education policy will come, and we have tried to introduce a component of entrepreneurships, and a lot of other issues are there. I will also try to give some of the important component to you, so that you will be having some idea in mind. So whenever such proposal will come to your desk, so I am sure that you will definitely pass it, and you will appreciate the effort made by the education division. As a comptroller, you always keep in mind that there is a 4P principle. 4P principle, that is a plan purposefully, prepare prayerfully. Just as we are going to the temple and then making, and then when we are going to temple, we are only discussing as far as our welfare is concerned. We are not discussing the other's welfare. Correct? It is always so. That's why prepare prayerfully and then proceed positively. That is also required. Then you will have to proceed positively, and finally pursue persistently. This 4P principle, in case you will follow, I am sure that we will be in position to make a right type of denting, and that is my commitment to ICR.
Thank you, sir, for valuable remarks and sessions, and I am sure that these guidelines will definitely help the comptrollers in their day-to-day functions.